Let's welcome the Manila Mavericks. Led by their coach, the winner of the Roland Garros Men's Singles Championship in 1998. From Spain, it's Carlos Moya. The winner of three ATP World Tour doubles titles from the Philippines, Treat Huey. Our next Maverick has won doubles titles in Rome and Madrid in the Master Series, and titles in Sydney and Brisbane in Australia. Eight doubles titles at Grand Slam level. From Canada, Daniel Nestor. A winner of the Quebec City Tournament on the WTA Tour. From Belgium, Kirsten Flipkens. A former finalist at Wimbledon, a former finalist at the US Championship, and once ranked number 8 in the world, from Australia, Mark Philippoussis. This year, a winner in Dusseldorf. He has 5 career singles titles to his credit, 7 career doubles titles. Currently ranked number 24 in the world, from Germany, Philipp Kohlschreiber. A winner this year of the ATP World Tour Masters Event 1000 in Canada, with 11 career singles titles to his credit, from France, Joe Wilfried Tsonga. And here come their opponents, the DBS Singapore Slammers, led by their coach, former doubles champion from Australia, Joshua Eagle. Our next slammer has wins this year in the Master Series in Canada and in London at the Queen's Club. 18 career doubles titles to his credit. From Brazil, Bruno Soares. Our next DBS slammer has 6 career singles titles on the WTA Tour, 3 Grand Slam doubles titles as well. From Slovakia, Daniela Hanukova. And now a man who's one of the emerging new stars of world tennis. He beat Rafael Nadal at Wimbledon this year. He is the wonder from down under. Please welcome Nick Kyrgios from Australia. Next up, a dual Grand Slam singles champion. He collected 11 singles titles during his career. From Australia, Patrick Rafter. In 2002, he won the men's singles title at Wimbledon. In 2001, he won the US Open men's singles crown. A former world number one from Australia, Leighton Hewitt. And now a man who this year has won tournaments in Stockholm and Rotterdam. He's ranked number 7 in the world and has 10 career singles titles to his credit. From the Czech Republic, Tomáš Berdych.
Taking it nice and easy, Tomáš Berdych, who's of course is enjoying that victory over Novak Djokovic, the current world number one, last night. And, that was the match that turned things around for the Slammers. Showed you how desperate they have been to get back to winning ways. It was only their third victory of the whole competition. Of course, so nice to do it. to be still giving 100%, even though they had no chance of winning the overall title. Mavericks have had some tight matches as well. And they've had an excellent record against the Slammers overall, beating them in all three of their previous meetings. So perhaps this afternoon will be an opportunity for the Slammers to gain some measure of revenge.
How well did they all play yesterday? Daniela was outstanding. Kyrgios and Hugh were unplayable in the men's doubles. Hopefully, Pat can make some inroads against Mark Philippoussis, but that's not going to be easy. Flip's had his number. Flip's been playing well.
Of course, he was beaten yesterday, wasn't he, by Fabrice Santoro, so perhaps this is a chance for Pat Rafter to finish on a high. Really, quick chat with him earlier, and he said that even though he's enjoyed the format and he's very much enjoyed being a part of the DBS Singapore Slammers, he just hasn't won enough matches. So on a personal note, he wanted to have done a little better. So perhaps, you know, he can finish on a high today by getting a win over Philippoussis. Let's get courtside now. And here from the captains, they're with Craig Willis.
I tell you what, there is a terrific feeling down here on this court. The last appearance of these two teams here in the Coca-Cola ITPTL. We've got young Adib John here. He's going to toss the coin to decide the choice of ends. Our chair umpire, the indestructible John Blom, has joined us, and our two coaches, Josh Eagle and Carlos Moyer. John, terms and conditions of the toss.
Thanks, Craig. Andrew Willis, the chief. We've got a special guest here to toss the coin today, and I'm going to ask my good friend Josh Eagle to make the call, because he gets very upset if I don't ask him. So go ahead and ask Josh to call. We've got IPTL.
I'm going to choose Coca-Cola, thank you.
Coca, and a good choice, because Adam John is a guest of our wonderful sponsors in Coca-Cola. Now you're going to toss the coin, young Adam John. Here we go. That is a fantastic spin. And it's come up IPTL. So Carlos Moyer is a happy man. Carlos?
We'll start serving. Mark Philippoussis.
Mark Philippoussis will start serving against
Big Patrick Rafter. He's been battling the big man, so hopefully he can put on an inspired effort in our last match today. It should be a good one, an all-Australian fair.
It's going to be a beauty. Can I ask you to, we're coming to the close of what has been a wonderful journey. Carlos, you had a great time?
Yeah, unbelievable. It would have been better if I didn't get injured, but we had a great experience. My teammates, they have been amazing, so it's been great to be here.
It's great to have you involved, and you've done an outstanding job as the coach of the Manila Mavericks. And Josh?
Yeah, look, it's been a sensational first-up event. It's only going to get bigger and better in the years to come. All the players have embraced it. They loved it, and it's been really fun to be part of.
Go out and enjoy the day. Well done, guys. Thank you. And ladies and gentlemen, the tennis underway in 3 minutes from now.
Yes, the players do have exactly 3 minutes to get nice and warmed up before play will commence. So they start with the Legends singles. Mark Philippoussis has had Pat Rafter's number throughout the competition so far. And then we've got a substitute, Philip Kohlschreiber, in for Joe Wilfried-Tsonga, who's got a slight problem with his arm. And, of course, they don't have any chance of winning the overall title now, so Tsonga has allowed Kohlschreiber the opportunity to get involved. He's been here for the whole 3 weeks, been practicing hard, so he should be good to go. And he plays Thomas Burdick, of course. Then we've got a bit of mixed doubles. Kirsten Flipkins and Daniel Nesta will take on Daniela Hantikova and Nick Kyrgios. And then Kirsten Flipkins will play Daniela in the women's singles. The fifth and final set, therefore, will be men's doubles. Daniel Nesta and Philip Kohlschreiber up against Bruno Suarez and Leighton Hewitt. Right, you should know the rules by now, but if you don't, here's a quick and final reminder. The four teams have been contesting a total of 24 matches in a round-robin format. 4 points awarded to each winning team per overall tie. Each match consists of 5 separate sets, and the home captain can decide the order in which those sets are played. And after the conclusion of all 5 of those sets, the team with the most games wins. It's as simple as that. So every game counts. Each set is the first of 6 games with a deciding point at deuce. And there's a shootout at 5-all. That's time sensitive. So that's very different to a normal tiebreak. They start the clock, and once that runs down, the player leading wins, whatever the score. But remember, there's a shot clock, and only 20 seconds are allowed between points. Team captains play their part too, with a timeout, a power point, and a substitution allowed per set. The power points in particular are very important, so keep an eye out for those.
Took a quick look at how these two teams have fared previously in this competition. They've played initially in Manila on day 3, match 6. And that's the first time, Robbie, I saw Mark Philippoussis play lights out, beat Pat Rafter 6-2 on that day. And of course, remember, it was the match in which Andy Murray suddenly started playing a little better, teaming up with Flipkins to win the mixed, and then that great match against Nick Kyrgios in the singles.
It was one of the few times where we saw it really come down to the very last point in the shootout. And of course, it was one of the longest rallies of the entire 5 sets, wasn't it? But eventually, Murray able to wear down Kyrgios, and what was a spectacular finish to that Maverick Slammers contest, Jason.
And of course, they met in Singapore on day 1 there. The ball was bouncing a little higher in Singapore. And of course, the Slammers were playing at home, and they had Serena Williams and Andre Agassi in their team for the first time. But Agassi looked a step slow, didn't he, against Philippoussis. So the Mavericks got off to a good start, and it was just a solid team performance. Williams, the only winner for the Slammers on that evening.
Yeah, I thought Flipkins and Nesta started to play much better as a team as well. And Huey and Songa, continued their rich vein of form. They were one of the standout teams. In fact, just having a look at the numbers, Songa has been one of the standout players, and they'll be a little disappointed he is not able to take to the court today. So Philip Kohlschreiber is under a bit of pressure, Jason. 5.23 games or more required. That's what Joe Wilfred's told him.
That was a good number, Sunday. So they also played in New Delhi. Day 3, match 17, and the Mavericks beat the Slammers 23-17. Kyrgios was in for Burdick in the men's singles initially, and that just shows you how well Burdick has played since then. Songa a little too good for him on that day, and I think Songa was the star of the show there, because then he teamed up with Daniel Nesta to beat Hewitt and Kyrgios 6-love.
Probably one of the stand-up performances as far as the doubles was concerned. Nesta really did play some good ball once Trent Huey got injured, and he had to step in for him. Speaking about stepping in and doing well for a fellow teammate, Philippoussis for Moya. He has been top draw. Of course, hashtag IPTL moment. You can get in touch with us via Twitter at IPTL. Both Jason and I would love to hear your comments. And of course, you can get a hold of me at Rob Koenig Tennis. We'd love to hear your thoughts of what's transpired in the last 17 days and what you think going forward.
So Legends singles initially. Mark Philippoussis batting first. Pat Rafter. We had a quick chat with Pat about 45 minutes or so before the start of the match, and he just said his main disappointment has been his inability to win sets, and he's also felt that the courts have been really slow. He said he's wanted some cheap points every now and then and simply hasn't been able to win them.
Well away from the back of the court, he can't hang with these guys. So when you're not getting any help from the court, it's so difficult to make inroads with your serve volley game, and then just getting duffed up in the baseline rallies. He's going to be all out of tech today. It's his instructions to us.
That's what we've been doing over the course of all of the matches, is keeping abreast of all the scores. I've been counting the amount of games that each player's won for their team, because, of course, each game counts, so that's important. Divided that by the number of sets that they've played, and we've come up with an average of games per set for each player. And when you look down the Mavericks, Mark Philippoussis is right up there, 5.67. He's only lost one set, remember. That was against Fabrice Santoro yesterday, who's been unbeaten in the competition so far, as far as the Legends are concerned. But Philippoussis boasts the best numbers of any of the Mavericks. That's how well he's played so far. Yeah, Rafter's been struggling. 3.33 is his average.
Okay, Manila.
What do you think generally about the speed of the courts, Robbie? I'm just thinking 12 months down the road, feedback to the tournament organisers. Have you liked the speed? Has it been slow enough? Has it not been quick enough? What would you like to see?
I would like it just sped up a little bit. I think on a scale of 1 to 5, the courts five being the fastest, one being the slowest. It's probably playing right around a one. In fact, chatting with Danny Nesta and Kirsten Flipkins yesterday, they were suggesting it's the slowest court they've ever played on as far as a hard court surface is concerned. So that gives you an idea on both the men's and women's tour. Nothing as slow as this.
And this is in a time when 15. All of the courts have been slowed down, haven't they? So if they're saying it's the slowest court they've ever played on, then it's got to be extremely slow. And especially as far as the legends are concerned, because we've got a lot of certain volleyers there, haven't we? A lot of players that play good all-court tennis. You have to allow them to do so.
But even for the baseliners, Jason, when the ball is coming onto the racket a little more on a faster court, your shot making is better. And I think it's good for everyone concerned. Oh, I love that volley. He knew he was out of position when he was having it hit that volley, so it's got to be short. He's got to force Philippoussis to come forward, so it's not a drop volley, it's just a short angle.
That's his favorite serve, isn't it? The big kicker out to the right-hander's backhand. But he just hasn't got any help from the courts at all. It's been relatively easy for opponents to return that serve. So that's neutralized Rafter's game.
Shot is it so well that backhand return, low, dipping to Rafter's feet.
Middle American goal, the happiness power.
So it's another game where Rafter has been up. Remember, he was up 40 love. Suddenly now it's a happiness power point for Philippoussis. So the pressure right back on the Aussie. It's playing for the Slammers.
It's unusual to play it this early in the set. Of course, they are crucial. Well, that's a challenge. The umpires overruled the lack of call. I don't think Rafter's going to bother with the challenge. Just wants confirmation, probably, but you can see the disappointment written large across his face. He simply has to make shots like that, and he can't afford to. He serves as well as Philippoussis. A head start. That's exactly what he's done. So it's the Mavs. They're up by two.
It's a laser forehand. Such a nice big swing arc. He uses those long levers to such good effect. He's a well-proportioned athlete, isn't he?
He is in great shape as well. Seen him in the gym every morning of this tour. He's taking care of business on his rehab as well. He's got a problem with his knee, and that's why he says he's slimmed down a little bit, so there's less stress on those joints. He's been so up for it. Every single set he's played. 15. Missed the volley. The footwork around the backhand initially was great, wasn't it? So serious about his tennis. Good hands there. Good. brilliant tennis. A superb get from Filipoussis at full stretch on the backhand. His penultimate shot. The shot of the rally for me. Lovely little approach here. How's that get from Rafter? No panic here from Filipoussis, and good anticipatory skills on display there. Filipoussis, they just had a bit too much time. That can happen. Nice bonus this for Rafter. He can make good use of this break point. Yeah. I didn't like the shot selection there on the short forehand, but Rafter did well. Get that one back in play. Filipoussis will be a little disappointed there, having broken early on. He's been able to make the most of it. It's the Mavericks who are up, but it's 2-1.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Right now at Homebase, get ready to host your perfect Christmas with up to 70% off artificial trees, Christmas lights and decorations. Or get a cut British-grown needle-last Nordman fir from just £10. Make your house your home this Christmas.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Time.
Well, I'm delighted to say we got team manager of the Singapore Slammers down courtside on headset with us. But worry about Nick Kyrgios there jumping in our conversation, Vikesh. Vikesh, thanks for joining Jason and I. And first of all, we'd just like to get your thoughts on everything that's unfolded with your team over the last couple of weeks. How's it been for you to be up close and personal with these guys for the last 17 days?
Yeah, thanks for having me. It's been a memorable experience. I think, look, some of the results haven't gone our way, but the team spirit has been unparalleled. It's been really good. The boys and Daniela has been fighting really hard. Some of the big points haven't quite gone our way in some matches, but the few wins we've got under our belt have been extremely epic. And, yeah, I think we're going to be back stronger next year. And I think it's been a big learning curve, but the team camaraderie has been unbelievable.
Vikash, Jason up in the commentary box with Robbie here. Speaking of 12 months down the road, given all that you've experienced in the last sort of 2 to 3 weeks, what will you do differently next time around?
Patrick. Singapore Slam.
Look, it's been, even the format was new for the players. We have to be smart in the draft that's going to come up in February, and obviously picking the right team in the strong areas. The court requires a big server as well, so I think we're going to take some advice from some of the experienced lads and take it from there.
Do you feel like it's almost been a disadvantage to have such a large and strong roster? It's been hard for Captain Josh Eagle to find his best team because he's almost been spoilt for choice.
Yeah, I think has been the case in certain extents. I think in the doubles for sure. Some of the other teams have stuck with certain pairings because they didn't have a choice with regards to their squad, and they gelled maybe a bit better. but I think, look, sometimes in sport it just, even though on paper we had probably arguably the strongest team, it just didn't pan out our way.
And Vikesh, just one final question as far as an owner is concerned of a team like this. Do you see yourselves being involved long term in the concept? Have you enjoyed it? Have you embraced it?
Yeah, of course. I think we're definitely in it for the long term. I think the concept has been a huge success. I think one of the biggest things for us as investors was seeing the commitment and the level of play from the players, and it's been outstanding. And I think that was one of the major boxes that needed to be ticked, and we're in it for the long haul. And you know, we were here to build the franchise and build fan bases, and feedback from the players has been awesome. Hats off to Mahesh, she's done a great job with the IPTL, and we're going to definitely come back fighting hard to win next year.
Well, hats off to you as well, Vikesh. Your team spirit, the energy that you guys have brought from the bench has been outstanding. And whatever you've done with your team, it's been outstanding, and it really has resonated with the fans. We've had so much positive feedback about your team, even though results haven't gone your way. So we thank you for that, and we thank you for investing in the IPTL, buddy.
Thank you very much. Have a good one, guys.
Thanks, Vikesh.
Cheers, bye.
Interesting talk about energy. The teams have created some really good quotes from Novak Djokovic post-match yesterday, and of course they've hit the press today as a result, and he said it's a unique energy that he's felt being a part of the UAE Royals, and he hasn't experienced that anywhere else, even the Davis Cup. He said it's been so much fun, and I think all of the players have said that, but when you hear it from the, you know, the current world number one, especially when he hasn't won a set yet. He's lost all three of his single sets, but he still had a fabulous experience and can feel the energy that all his teammates have created over the course of the last 3 weeks. That says a lot.
Okay. Manila Mavericks.
So this opening set, a little tighter than perhaps it looked like it was going to be initially when Filippoussis has had the early break. We're back on serve now, midway through it. It's the Mavericks who lead, 3-2.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Right now at Homebase, get ready to host your perfect Christmas with up to 70% off artificial trees, Christmas lights and decorations. Or get a cut British-grown needle-last Nordman fir from just £10. Homebase. Make your house your home this Christmas.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Time.
Sensational tennis from both players. World class.
The type of movement that you require at the net is completely different than the kind of foot exercises you do at the back of the court. Good hands, but Filippoussis was ready.
15-15.
Again, the moment Rafter's digging up balls, it's always going to be difficult for him to withstand the firepower of Flip.
Oh!
Singapore.
Brilliant.
It's good effort from Rafter. Told us earlier he's going to go out all guns blazing. Didn't plan to play too much tennis after this. Body's hurting a little bit, the shoulder, the hips. Of course, played a lot of tennis. That's what all these younger players at the very top of the game need to be wary of. Push their bodies so often and so hard. You have to take care of your rehab, look after your body, get in the ice baths. Burdick spending plenty of time there warming up, and he was in the gym this morning for a good 2 hours as well.
He was doing sprints and running as well thereafter. Outside, not in a slightly air-conditioned shelter of the gym.
That's what's been so good, I think, about this competition for all the players. They've been working hard in the off-season training. Gym's been packed every morning. They've all got their trainers with them. They've been practicing as well off-site. And then on location at each venue, they've been able to play competitive tennis. So they've been able to try and put what they're practicing on into matches. That gives them invaluable feedback at this stage going into 2015 next year.
30. Got a piece of it.
It's going to be tight, this. We might get down to a shootout first up. As it stands, it's the Mavericks who leads. All games to three.
Sponsored by Bet365.
At Argos, get set for up to half-price cameras. This Canon Ixus with 8x zoom, now only $49.99. Get set for up to 60% off electrical personal care. Like this Philips shaver, now just $47.99. Go Argos!
Sponsored by Bet365.
Nice. Team Burdick, I haven't seen one of those t-shirts before. Like it. Here in these parts, it's Friday and Saturday. No one's working today. Stadium should fill up a little later on.
15.
It was interesting talking to the Slammers manager earlier. It'd be nice if they finished on a high and got a win today off the back of that famous victory last night. They've competed well. Nothing wrong with that. On occasion, though, I don't think they've picked the right team and haven't quite been able to gel all at the right time, at the same time. Had great individual performances, but sometimes the base level of play of one or two of their players hasn't been good enough. Hantikova struggled initially, didn't she, in Manila, but playing a lot better now. Suarez, when he's been called upon in the doubles, hasn't necessarily played his best tennis. Kyrgios a little up and down with Hewitt in the doubles. You know, when they've been good, they've been brilliant. When they've been bad, they've been very poor. And Rafter, despite his best efforts, has been a little lightweight sometimes against some of the bigger hitting legends.
Whoa! Oh. 3:50.
It's a little backhand return that's impressed me so much from Philippoussis over the course of the competition. Great strength in his arm there. Low enough. And, does really well today. Nice solid hold there. So Philippoussis is looking good. He's got a lead of 5-4 now for the Mavericks.
Sponsored by Bet365.
World of Tanks. Take a quick break, choose your tank, and have a blast. World of Tanks. Play for free at playtank.co.uk.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Additional pressure on the shoulders of Pat Rafter now, serving to stay in the set. On a couple of occasions, that's been a problem for Rafter, first serve percentage. A little better today. Nicely done.
Rafter probably wants a competition to go on another 18 days. Now that he's starting to find some good form in the forecourt.
Sure the body would hold up, but the mind's there, isn't it? The commitment is there.
It's never been questionable.
Enough on that. A little slider there, right into the honeypot, wasn't it?
where you talk about the court not giving you enough help. Ball's not skidding away from Philippoussis enough and rushing him.
Game. Singapore.
Such good control of the racket face there. Full stretch. That's so important if you want to become a good volleyer. So after an early break for Philippoussis, we have to sit back strongly. And this set will be decided by a 5-minute shootout. It's an excellent start. Measured backhand that one. There's always a tendency there. Try and hit it too hard. Desperate to hit a winning shot. And of course, it's easily missed.
Enough to trouble Philippoussis. He's made it. That was a good rip from Flip.
Singapore's name is
after all over it. Par volley, so nice and deep. Just buys him enough time. Cover the down the line pass. Anything in the court would have sufficed. He knew that.
Again, it's such a sensible approach. This one does look a little risky every now and then under pressure. Just about 3 minutes left on the clock now. Rolling back the years there.
3-2, Manila Mavericks.
Covering that cross court nice and early. So difficult to get it over his head.
Makeable shot. Got to get the elevation there. Three apiece, 2 minutes left. What a volley. Absolutely superb. You go deep with that, you do give your opponents another shot at the pass. You drop it nice and short on a court like this where it stays low. There's very little chance for your opponent. Lovely control. That was a power point. So that would have counted double for Rafter, but the serve was simply too hot to handle. Couldn't hit it any better.
4-0.
Philippoussis with a slight lead, and he's playing his power point now, so this counts double for him if he wins it. All right, all sorts of problems with the ball toss there after, and perhaps would have been better off not hitting it at all. Especially, perhaps should have stayed at the baseline. So that counts double. What a nightmare that is for Rafter. And that surely has cost him this set now. Philippoussis with a decent lead of 3 points and only 30 seconds left to go. That'll do it. Philippoussis runs down the clock and gets it done against Matt Rafter in a shootout. It was a tight set, the tightest they've had in this competition. But again, Philippoussis eventually prevails. 6-5.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Right now at Homebase, get ready to host your perfect Christmas with up to 70% off artificial trees, Christmas lights and decorations. Or get a cut British-grown needle-last Nordman fir from just £10. Homebase. Make your house your home this Christmas.
What are you in the mood for? Do you want to have fun with the girls?
I'm ready to take this party by storm. Like, I'm woman, hear me roar. You're a really good dancer.
So are you.
Thanks, I know.
Are you looking for love?
Such a cliche. You seem like a really nice guy, but why do you think I go on so many bad dates?
You could overthrow an empire.
Spartacus!
That is not my name.
Or become the true detective.
You ever see something like this?
No, sure.
Something happened to a girl, and we need to know if any of you knew her.
Of course I'm dangerous. I'm police.
And uncover the biggest murder mysteries.
Sherlock Holmes, Jane Watson.
He's a criminal genius.
No!
Sorry, I mistook you for a corpse.
Whatever your mood.
Triple smiley face with tongue protruding.
Come on!
Oh, can I say I'm in a good mood?
Sky's got it covered with the latest and greatest box sets. Available on demand now.
Power resides where men believe it resides.
Before it returns in the spring, your chance to catch up with every episode of Game of Thrones.
Winter is coming.
We will take back what was stolen from me. We will lay waste to armies and burn cities to the ground.
When you play the Game of Thrones, you win or you die.
The epic saga from the very beginning. Set your series link to record it all. Starts next Saturday from 9 on Sky Atlantic HD.
Sponsored by Bet365.
So a good start by the Mavericks. Mark Lapuse is getting Pat Rafter 6-5. Of course, what impressed me most there in that set, Robbie, was the fact that they were so competitive, even though neither team has a chance of winning the title. So again, that's what's been the standout feature, I think, over the course of the last 3 weeks for me.
Yeah, it's competition of the highest order. No quarter asked, none given once again between these two guys. Mark didn't serve as well as what we've seen him serve throughout the course of the last couple of matches. Their first serve percentage was low, but winner's time for serious ratio was very healthy considering all of that. Pat volleyed well. You can see how often he came in 37 times, a much better ratio of net points won. Mark just playing the bigger points a little better, and really that one poor ball toss that cost Rafter in the tiebreaker. Apart from that, there was almost nothing to choose between those two guys in the opening set.
So Philippoussis with a win. He's lost just the one set so far in this competition. And he's got an average he can be very proud of. 5.7 games a set. Up next, Philip Kohlschreiber. I haven't seen him before, and you might think, where did he spring from? But, we did have a chat with him initially in Manila, and he's been on the court side throughout, just in case any of the major players got injured. Songa's had a problem with his arm for over a week now, but he's been so desperate to continue to play for the Mavericks, he's done so. And of course, with no chance to win the title, he's sitting on the side today and allowing Kohlschreiber to get involved in the action. It's not going to be easy, though. He's taking on Thomas Berdych. Berdych, of course, beating Novak Djokovic yesterday evening, handing the title to the Micromax Indian Aces. Remember, winning team won $1 million in prize money. That goes to the owners of the team, and then they decide whether they want to pass any of that on to any of the players or anybody else involved in the team's operation. So men's singles, the second set in match 23 here in Dubai. It'll be Thomas Burdick to get us underway against Philip Kohlschreiber.
15.
Working really hard every day. It's a Kohlschreiber. Doing some off-season training. So this is nice for him to step into a much more intense environment to see where his game's at.
Historically, it's been difficult, though, hasn't it, for players playing in their first set of this competition, either when they've been introduced by team captain or when they've flown in. They've only been playing perhaps for a certain period. They've all struggled getting used to it. The speed of the court, the intensity, the energy. But they've all adapted quickly thereafter. Kohlschreiber is a very solid player, isn't he, Rob?
He really does use his legs well. Wonderful rotation with the upper body. Generates a lot of pace for a little guy.
Impressed with how hard Burdick has trained. He had a little bit of a holiday after finishing at the O2. Played poorly there, didn't he? And he said so himself when we had a chat with him a week or so ago. He said it was disappointing, obviously, but it was nice to have a break. Long season. He's been looking after his body and been working very, very hard and being in the best possible shape for the start of next season. It's not something you usually associate with Burdick, is it? Working extremely hard off court. It's been really nice to witness just how hard these players have worked.
Yeah, off the back of a nice couple of days in the Maldives after the World Tour Finals. From day one, when he joined the IPTL, he's been really dialed in.
Pat Raft has joined us from the DBS Singapore Slammers bench. Thanks very much for doing so, Pat.
Thanks.
Firstly, unlucky. I thought you played some decent tennis in that. It was just the one bad ball toss, right?
Oh, it was a bit more than that, I guess. You know, the thing is, you know, we keep saying unlucky. The problem is I've said that after 10 matches. It's not unlucky. It's just it's just a funny format, and I think a big serve is really important in this, and that's not my style.
Have you been impressed generally with the overall quality of the legends in particular? Did you think when you first pitched up here at the start of the competition that it wasn't going to be as intense as it has been?
Yeah, well, I played really well in the legends end of last year. I didn't see this coming, and I have hardly lost a match in many years. So I've just got absolutely cleaned up over the last couple, 2.5 weeks. And I've been really surprised. I thought I'd be right. I've been close a couple of times, but haven't been able to really get the biggies.
I haven't been involved very much in sort of your team as such an experienced individual, and obviously your Australian Davis Cup captain as well. But what would you do differently now if you had your time again as a team at the start of this competition? What have you learned, and what do you think you could have done a little better to get better overall results?
That's a good question, mate. I think we've done pretty well. You know, we've tried really hard. It hasn't been a lack of trying, but same as all the teams. I think they've all put in a great effort. I just think we've just been a little bit outplayed. I sort of had to bring that team down, unfortunately. I think maybe if I was going to change anything, change me. put in someone who could have won some matches, and then it could have been a really good team.
And just give us a bit of insight from an Australian perspective as to what's expected from someone like Nick Kyrgios next season. What do you think would be a good ranking for him to finish with, and what do you expect from him, you know, at the majors?
Nick's a hard one to call, mate. He's still raw. The players will probably start working him out a little bit. This will be his second year on tour, and it's always that danger year. I still think he needs to understand the hard work and what's required. He has all the potential in the world, but he needs to understand that these guys train and work incredibly hard, and they're very mentally tough. So he's got a bit of maturing to do in that department. I'd love to see him finish top 20, but he's going to have to put in a very, very big year.
And do you find him open-minded? He's got so much experience to draw upon, for instance, on your bench. You know, Leighton, players of that caliber, you've had some great ones down the years in Australia. Is he making good use of that experience?
He understands, but he's failing to really act on it yet. He knows what he has to do, but it's hard work. I don't know if he hasn't mentally committed to that yet. And some kids are ready for it, and others aren't. And I would say at this stage, he needs to understand that there's a lot of hard work to be done, and he's got to make that commitment. And once he makes that commitment, you'll see his full potential. But until then, I don't think we'll see the full potential of Nick. And I hope he realises this in a year, because as every year passes, he'll be maybe, you know, it'll be harder and harder. So, you know, that's the point we keep stressing to him. It's not a negative, it's just an awareness for him.
Well, thanks, Pat. Really nice to talk to you. It's been a joy to watch you play, even though you haven't had the results you would have wanted. And hopefully we'll see you at some stage in the future in this format in one capacity or another.
Yeah, thanks, guys. This has been an unbelievable event. I'm a big, big fan of it. I think this has a really big place in tennis. So I'm really excited for Mahesh and the IPTL. And let's hope for really big things in the next 10 years.
Thanks, Pat.
Thanks, Paddy.
Thanks, guys.
40-50. Singapore.
Two games to one. Looking good. No breaks of serve as yet. So it's the Slammers are up. 2-1 in this set. Check out the overall score. That's what's important. 7 games apiece.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Right now at Homebase, get ready to host your perfect Christmas with up to 70% off artificial trees, Christmas lights and decorations. Or get a cut British-grown needle-last Nordman fir from just £10. Homebase. Make your house your home this Christmas.
Sponsored by Bet365.
On serve. It's a little leg drive, deep knee bend, using in the major muscle groups, and then transfers all the energy through his body, culminating in a nice good wrist snap. And he's got another ace. Yeah. Has he?
Singapore's lab is trying to get the call on the center
side. Not sure. Percent out, which of course in tennis is 100% in.
Two apiece. Oh, it's a lovely shot.
Lovely.
He's got a great backhand on it. But occasionally, he can be a little more aggressive with the forehand. That's why I'll run around it. The angle he creates there by dropping it over short. So a bit more spin, a little less pace. It's a lovely shot.
Raul Sharma has made the trip from India to Dubai. Of course, he will be delighted. One of the main owners of the Micromax Indian Aces. Co-founder of Micromax is Raul.
Just popped in to pick up the trophy, right?
Very nice.
Very good chat with him last week in New Delhi. Obviously, he really enjoyed that. He said it was a unique experience. This guy has had so much success in business and, of course, is worth fortunes. But that experience is one that money can't buy. To see the best two players in the world going toe-to-toe, playing that well in India, 15,000 people going nuts, and you're sat on the court. And he just said words couldn't describe it.
Just picking up the trophy tonight.
A bit of cash and a large brown envelope as well.
Winning team gets $1 million. On his discretion, what he wants to do with it.
It's always nice to have that discretion. Of course, we're in committed relationships, Robbie, so we don't have that anymore, do we? So the starting point receiver has a choice of sides. No surprises really. Cole Schreiber electing to receive from the backhand. So well with Djokovic yesterday. He's coming out here, all the pressure's on him to repeat that performance and beat Cole Schreiber handily. It's panned out like that so far. Mavericks lead, 3-2. They've got a 2-game lead overall.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Dior Homme, Eau for Men, the new fragrance by Christian Dior.
Sponsored by Bet365.
So, Immortal Samurai 007, watching the legend singles between the Mavericks and Singapore Slammers. Big fan of Pat Rafter. What about Anthony Gorayeb? Mr. IPTL Moments is Ivanovic. Weaving her magic.
Is that just any moment that Anna's involved in? She must be a big fan. She has been a bit of a revelation. She's so enjoyed it. And, so many of the other players have too.
Pratchy's been enjoying watching Rafter playing Goran after 13 years of incredible 2001 Wimbledon final.
No one will forget that, will they? The one that was played on the Monday, obviously, and well, not obviously if you weren't around then or you haven't seen it, but it was. And as a result, they opened the gates and it was just full of tennis fans. Normally, the tickets are given out by ballot, so you had a lot of Aussies there, and of course, a lot of Goran's fans as well. The atmosphere was electric,
so unique, wasn't it?
Incredible! Incredible. Oh. course, it went the distance, and Goran, having come so close on so many of occasions, eventually winning it as a wild card. Couldn't even get in the draw that year, his ranking was so low. Who could forget the tears of joy welling up in his eyes as he held serve that final time? Pointing up to the big guy upstairs, just needing a little bit of help, and obviously thanking him for all the help that he'd given him over the course of the 2 weeks there. Incredible scenes. It's a lovely return.
The taste of his own medicine. In a row.
It's adapted well. 4-2 is the lead now.
It's been one of the advantages of the travelling with us for the week, so he's been seeing how the format unfolds, and it's not very much a fay with the rules and the conditions.
No jet lag either, so that always helps. Like that in plenty of time. You've got so many options, you can do anything with the ball and just overcook it.
Taking the ball so early. That's why I'm such a big fan of developing juniors in that manner, because even if you are smaller in stature, you still have the ability and to compete with the bigger, stronger guys.
More with that return. Not sure they knows it. He's got a chance to make amends here.
Presses forward, totally committed to the shot.
Still break point though. A lot of doubles on big points in big matches against his peers. Similar scenario this afternoon. Maverick's looking good now. Four up, 11-7.
Sponsored by Bet365. Join us at Autosport International and the Performance Car Show, where the world of motorsport meets performance road cars. Get close to amazing racing and road cars and experience the live action arena at the NEC Birmingham from the 8th to the 11th of January. Don't miss out. Book your tickets today.
Sponsored by Bet365.
So Cole Schreiber serving for the side.
Sunil Gavaskar. So taking a selfie there. Is it a selfie when you're at tennis?
It is indeed. Let's get another of those selfie sticks for Christmas. Blue Bang Manor has everything. And you could get it fashioned like a cricket.
A little handle. Must be dialed in from the very beginning as Cole Schreiber.
He's played so well. He's put a foot wrong. Set point. Game. Some lovely variation to the match court. How's that for commitment? He spent 9 and 3 weeks practicing, waiting for an opportunity, hoping to get involved. He's been given the opportunity. Incredibly well. Thomas Burdick, 6-2. Mavericks up 12-7.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Join us at Autosport International and the Performance Car Show, where the world of motorsport meets performance road cars. Get close to amazing racing and road cars and experience the live-action arena at the NEC Birmingham from the 8th to the 11th of January. Don't miss out. Book your tickets today.
I still don't understand why you're leaving us, Aggie.
Earn enough money. Get over this rat race before I'm too old.
But what are you going to do in the Cotswolds?
Build a home. Fit in. Agatha Raisin, new to the village.
Tell me, what normally wins the quiche competition?
The winner of the best quiche is...
I did not murder anyone.
Then who did?
You prove there's a murderer in the village, people will stop blaming you. You might even be liked.
I'm telling you, there is something going on here.
Agatha Raisin?
Yes, there are suspects everywhere.
Stop playing detective.
This is relevant to my murder inquiry.
Oh, stop it.
Police!
What's wrong with you people?
Agatha Raisin and the Quiche of Death. Boxing Day at 8:30, only on Sky One HD.
Once and for all, who would win? Me or you?
His arms are like twice the size of yours.
Two worlds collide when the Flash and Arrow meet.
Harry has powers. Oliver has a bow and arrow.
Sky One brings you a special crossover event.
You missed. No.
Starts in the Flash Tuesday at 8 and concludes in Arrow Thursday at 8 on Sky One HD. Sponsored by Bet365.
He's another player who want that result to go on the head-to-head. I don't know if he's going to be able to pull it off, but he certainly will try. But did everything well. Did look how effective he was behind that first serve. And backing up the line really is gorgeous. That single-hander when it's in full flow provides plenty of eye candy. Burdick didn't serve well. And paid the price. Just shows you in the men's game when the serve is off, you can struggle very easily. Such fine margins between guys ranked, you know, top 10 in the world, and those guys who are even inside the top 50. Cole Schreiber is a guy who's known for giant killing. When he's on his game, he's caused some of the best players on the planet a fair bit of trouble.
So Mark Philippoussis getting a win over Pat Rafter initially. That was a tight set. in the shootout. Puss is doing just enough to get a lead midway through that shootout and then just ran down the clock. And Cole Schreiber in for Joe Wilfried Tsonga, who's got a problem with his arm, beating Thomas Burdick handily, 6-2. So up next, got a bit of mixed doubles, Kirsten Flipkins and Daniel Nestor. Instead, Daniela Hantikova and Nick Kyrgios. Then we've got some women's singles. Flipkins in action again, and so is Hantikova. So they've got a set to warm up in the mix before they'll go head-to-head in the ladies' singles. And then to round off the action, a bit of men's doubles, Cole Schreiber will be back a little later on, partnering Daniel Nestor against Bruno Suarez and Leighton Hewitt. That's the trophy that will be handed to the Micromax Indian Aces a little later on today, and deservedly so. They've been the strongest team, I think, throughout the competition, and then had the added bonus of having Roger Federer spearhead their team in New Delhi. That, very much the highlight for me as a fan and a commentator courtside, watching those two go toe-to-toe a few days ago in India for the first time. Those two have played tennis. This is match 23. It's the third set of it. Time now for a bit of mixed doubles. Flipkins and Nestor against Hantikova and Kyrgios. Overall score, Mavericks up 12-7 against the Slammers.
Third set.
It was interesting, wasn't it, Robbie, listening to Pat Rafter talk about what his hopes are for Nick Kyrgios, how much of a talent he believes he is, but how important the next couple of seasons are going to be for him, and how quickly he wants him to mature.
Yeah, I guess at the end of the day, it's down to Nick, isn't it? You can get as much advice as you want from the best players. It's the individual who's got to really have personal accountability. Sometimes the youngsters need to crash and burn, and hopefully that happens a little earlier on in their career, and that crash and burn is not too severe, because sometimes that's when you realize it best, when you've had that adversity and you've been set back, and then you realize, hang on, I've wasted a couple of years. Someone like Roger Federer, I was watching a documentary on him the other day, and he suggested that, you know, oh, that's beautiful. After he had initial success, he still felt like he wasted 18 months to 2 years of his career not knuckling down, not surrounding himself with the best possible people. And so once he got that right, once he understood the importance of it, that's when his career really did take off and flourish. And I guess Nadal's been the exception in that department. From such a young age, he's been so dialed in. Discipline and commitment has been unwavering. That Kyrgios has got the goods, but the shots, as Pat suggested, it's not enough these days. You've got to be so strong between the years. You've got to be good for long periods of the year if you want to be world number one. You know, do you want to be a Grand Slam champion on one occasion, or do you have the ambition to be a multiple Grand Slam champion? I think that's another question as well, isn't it, Jason?
It takes a special kind of mindset, doesn't it, to want to continually push yourself and try and improve. Some players aren't prepared to do that. A lot of success and a lot of money, happy being top 10 in the world, maybe winning the occasional Grand Slam. I remember talking to Tony Pickard about that. He used to coach Stefan Edberg and did so throughout his career. And he said, you know, Stefan's a very special individual. Wants to be world number one. He wants to win every single Grand Slam he enters. Now, a lot of players want to do that, but he's prepared to put in the work. Same with Boris Becker, Pete Sampras, Andre Agassi, all the great champions. down the years, but there are a lot that have been ranked, you know, 6, 7, 8 in the world, earn a lot of money, but never been prepared to give 100% day in, day out.
It's the one thing I think about David Nalbandi, and it kind of resonates with me when I think about him, because it was a guy with an immense amount of talent, but didn't have the discipline like some of the other peers, Djokovic, Murray, Nadal. Ball striking wise, he was right up there.
Well, speaking of ball striking wise, I don't want to disrespect Mark Philippoussis, but it was a similar scenario, right? I remember watching him as a junior. His talent, his incredible strength, serve, physique. I mean, you know, a couple of Grand Slam finals, no Grand Slam titles, 8 in the world, highest ranking. He looks more focused now, and he looks in better shape now than he ever was. It would be so interesting to talk to him, wouldn't it, about what he would do again differently at the start of his career if he was the same age as Kyrgios now.
Yes, that's why it would be almost a very good idea for Mark and Nick to sit down. Because I think Mark would be the first to agree with you, Jason, that he'd do things differently.
With that. Nice hands. A little cross from Nesta. I mean, I'm so impressed with the timing of his movement at the net and the fact that he never tries to hit the ball too hard. He's got confidence in his ability to place the ball perfectly each and every time he hits the ball.
Game, Manila Venomous. 2-1.
A nice, tidy start to the mixed doubles. It's looking good, aren't they? They've got a 2-1 lead here. They've won the first two sets, so they're 14-8 up now.
Sponsored by Bet365.
At Richer Sounds, we're passionate about bringing your music and movies to life. This LG 49-inch 4K smart TV is just $899, giving you the perfect picture at an incredible price. With a friendly team of experts and fully qualified installers at our 53 stores nationwide, we'll make your home entertainment dream come true.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Problems initially with her serve, Daniela, in Manila. She was struggling with the 20 seconds allowed between points. She was still thinking about her technique on serve because she's changed it slightly since she started working with Carlos Rodriguez. And there were so many things to think of initially about the overall format that a few of the players panicked, and she was one of them. Much more comfortable now, much more confident too. It was really interesting, wasn't it, Robbie, to talk to Daniela about her experiences in this competition.
She's loved every minute of it, Jason. She was suggesting to us that she's been on tour for, 14 years now. And in the last 3 weeks, she's made so many new friends. She's got so much more insight as to what goes on in other players' lives. And it's... she's really blossomed as a result of it. She said now that when she goes back out on tour, she'll actually have 10 or 12 people out there who she generally will be rooting for and will have an affinity towards. And I think it's so nice because this tournament, if anything, has showed us the other side of the players. It's shown us their characters, their personalities. And I think that's so good for any sport.
Oh, lovely combo. There's again, just no panic at all. So often you see him hit the right shot at the right time. Lovely feel. These two have combined well as a mixed pairing. Wipkins and Nesta. Both excel this format.
15.
Disappointed with his backhand volley because the initial pickup was sublime. Not gives too much away, does he, Nesta? Tough competitor.
It's a silent assassin. Just goes about his business. He's in his little bubble.
Just keeps it back to his belly.
RP, Danny Nesta.
So a power point in play, counts double for the receivers. Let's see what Kyrgios can do here.
Okay, Manila.
Move well enough to that final shot.
Manila,
Slammers will be a little disappointed with that. Mavericks lead. 4-1.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Join us at Autosport International and the Performance Car Show, where the world of motorsport meets performance road cars. Get close to amazing racing and road cars and experience the live-action arena at the NEC Birmingham from the 8th to the 11th of January. Don't miss out. Book your tickets today.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Time.
Oh, it's such an effective return, that one. We've seen it used an awful lot. Why the player at the net there has to be ready for that one.
You've almost got to expect that it is going to come to you.
Philip Kohlschreiber's joined us from the Mavericks bench. Philip, Jason Goodall up in commentary here. Thanks for joining us and congratulations. Played a good set of tennis there.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Very happy to be finally in a team, and I was very excited about the match and very motivated.
Yeah, some of the other players that have played their first set of tennis in this format have struggled, but not you. But I guess the advantage is you've been part of this tour, as it were, for the last 3 weeks, so no jet lag, and you've had an opportunity to watch the format. What have you liked about it most?
Oh, I think it's very effective, very quick. You know, there's no time to waste on the court, especially for your game. If you on top of the game, it's pretty good that you play many points as possible in short time. And like you mentioned, I had the chance to really watch everything, learn, and I was practicing like hell, so I was ready for today.
I like that, Philip. Robbie alongside Jason here. You have been working hard. We've been seeing you both on and off the practice court, working well. And Phil, how's your preparations gone for the season? About how far down the road are you now? How many more weeks before you're totally ready?
Well, I think so far I'm doing very happy, doing very well. I'm happy with everything. And overall, you know, next week I make a week off. It was also very tough for all the traveling and hard practice. And basically after Christmas, I will really go one more week and then go start in Doha.
And what will your goals be for 2015, Philip?
Well, of course, I would love to break into the top 20 again and do for sure better than my highest ranking. I didn't play the Australian Open last year, so I guess I have a good chance there to make some points and improve in my ranking. And of course, you always want to stay healthy, but I think I worked in a few on a few points in my game, and I hope to see the improvement during the season.
Yeah, what do you think you need to improve specifically to challenge the sort of best players in the world inside the top 20 on a regular basis? Just give us a bit of insight into that, if you wouldn't mind.
I don't mind. I think I'm always been a very tough competitor. You really have to fight on the court with me. But sometimes I struggle, you know, to finish some points. So I try to get more power, trying to be more aggressive in my game. I got nice advice from Boris, you know, see that you have to always put another extra 2-3% of something different in your game. And my game plan would be to go more to the net, be more aggressive. I think I have great ground strokes, and I have to convert the good I have to finish more often to the net.
Yeah, I think it's definitely a gap in the game, I think, Phil. If you have that ability with big ground strokes like yours, when you've got the best players on the move, then to come in and finish the point off, I think it's vitally important, because these guys defend so well.
Yeah, you're absolutely right, and I got a lesson during the 2 weeks from Pat, you know. I asked for help, and it worked out pretty well. He gave me some great tips about the volley and how should I approach, you know, the right timing. And I think I'm still pretty young, able to learn a lot still in my tennis, even if I think I did quite well in the past, but it's always space for improvement.
He didn't charge you too much for the lesson, did he?
No, it was free. Actually, I have to say, he's a really great guy, you know, like so positive, and I think he's enjoying everything, and that's how you can feel it when you work with him on the court.
It's always nice when you can get feedback like that from a great champion like Pat. Well, thanks for joining us, and I wish you all the very best in 2015.
Thanks a lot, guys.
Thanks, Phil. Oh, it's beautiful. So early. It's when he's returned best. No big cuts at the ball, just use the body weight to lean on it.
Game. Third set.
I can't argue with that. I did suggest at the beginning of the sets that Lipkins and Nesta have become a formidable partnership. But so it's proved. Danny struggled initially in Manila, and he's finished very strongly here in Dubai. They win the set 6-1.
Sponsored by Bet365.
At Richer Sounds, we're passionate about bringing your music and movies to life. Get this Samsung 55-inch curved Ultra HD smart TV for just $1,299 and purchase a second Samsung product to claim up to a £200 cash reward from Samsung. With 53 stores nationwide, a friendly team of experts and fully qualified installers, we'll make your home entertainment dream come true.
Starts Thursday, live only on the Sky Sports Darts channel.
Hey everybody, it's Sky Movies Adventure Time!
Step this way!
Ladies and gentlemen, the great Gonzo!
Oh, nice trip!
Awesome!
Step into the adventure with Sky Movies this Christmas. Sky, believe in better.
Give me a reason to wake up in the morning.
Don't have a clue. I'm waiting for the dog to die so I can shoot myself.
Sponsored by Bet365.
She's not chasing Craig Willis, though, is she? So, three sets down, two to go. Kirsten Flipkens against Daniela Hantikova. And I think Daniela's just having a bit of treatment courtside there. Let's hope that she hasn't pulled something in the mixed doubles. I mean, that's been the other thing that all the players have said, Robbie. A, how much they've really enjoyed it. B, how intense it's been. And that's surprised them. But because it's been so intense, then one or two of them have picked up niggly injuries, haven't they, along the way?
Yep, you've got to be 100% committed. You've got to come well prepared. And I think that's what a lot of players will realize this time next year. Stay in good shape if you're going to be playing at the IPTL and work towards getting yourself best possible frame of mind and physically be right on top of your game. Of course, Daniela was right on top of her game this morning, caught her in the gym, working out very hard. She was doing a lot of squats, a lot of lateral movements, upper body. I wouldn't be surprised if she's just a little stiff, Jason, perhaps a slight tweak of a muscle, nothing major.
Well, ask them though.
Yeah, and I guess
that's what I suggest, but ask them if they're happy to do it.
Downside is,
can
of course,
the order
no reserves. Yeah. What they want to do is change the order around, I think, to give her an opportunity to get a little bit of treatment and then come back later and play. I mean, that's got to be the way to go, hasn't it, Robbie?
Just give her a chance to get some treatment.
You want to tell your...
We're going to put the guys on.
Yeah, so good decision from the captains.
Yeah, change the order. Fans want to see them play, right?
Yep.
You want to hit a little bit like...
So obviously, respect Carlos Moya, the captains of the Mavericks, to suggest that's okay. Oh,
yeah, so it'll be the men's doubles then.
Just take what you need. Just take. If you don't need 3 minutes, don't take 3 minutes.
We'll try about Nesta, because Nesta's just played, as has
Nicolas,
because
it's
Bruno Suarez and Leighton Hewitt. Play doubles for the Slammers today. So a slight change-up. Kyrgios has been partnering Hewitt most of the time, so I think it might just allow Bruno to get out there, turn his arm over. Nesta will be good to go, as will Coley. Of course, he beat Burdick earlier today, 6-2. So then it will be nice to see the women round off the action at set number 5. I'm sure Hantikova will want to play, but she's enjoyed every minute of it here in Dubai. Played some great tennis yesterday. What you don't want to do in the last match of the competition is obviously get injured when you start talking about getting ready for 2015.
Yeah, so you've got to be smart about managing your body. So it'll be a slightly extended warm-up after the players
2 minutes.
Have just sorted out the change in order.
It's all about trying to get the balance right, isn't it? Players are here to compete, but it's entertainment. So you want to put on a good show for the fans. If there's any possibility of Daniela getting out there and hurting herself or of the team having to default to that particular set, we don't want that to happen, because these two matches today won't decide the overall title. That's already been won by Mike Max Indian Aces. So, sensible decision. Sense has prevailed. It's not always the case in sport. I'm glad to report that that is the case here this afternoon.
1 minute.
It's kind of like a Bruno Suarez, Daniel Nesta, someone that plays just doubles. Is there a place for them on your team, or 12 months down the road, do you think it's more valuable as a captain to have two good quality singles players to choose from, as opposed to one singles player and doubles player?
It's a great question, especially if you've got two singles players, one of which you can play some good doubles, I mean, a guy like Philip Kohlschreiber would be a good example. You might be inclined to drop a double specialist and have two singles options. Especially if one guy goes off, one guy gets a little tired or a little injured, and you've got somebody like Kohlschreiber as a backup there to share the responsibility. It's about rotating the squad like a good manager would do. Understanding it on a certain day, even if a guy isn't injured, but he's a bit jaded and the other guy's feeling fresher, bring him into the squad. So I think having two singles guys gives you a little bit more flexibility. You wouldn't want to be asking Bruno Suarez to step in and play singles, right? Because it'd be so tough for him.
No, it's whether you can afford the luxury of having a double specialist as well as singles players, and whether you know, the rules dictate that there might be a limit on a certain number of players in each team 12 months down the road. So it'd be interesting to see how this format evolves down the years. I'm sure the rules are going to be tweaked after this first season. Get plenty of feedback from the players, broadcasters and the fans. Mahesh Bhupathi, very open-minded in that respect. To respect him an awful lot more as a result.
Both set. Singapore's nemesis.
So we're all set to quick shuffle of the order of play. Means that it's at men's doubles now, which is set number four. Suarez and Hewitt against Nesta and Kohlschreiber.
15.
Bruno Suarez averaging just over four games a set for his team captain, 4.09 to be exact. Kraus calculations come up with that average.
Yeah. Those are pretty intricate, aren't they? A lot of detail gone into those.
Always. High maintenance formula, but it works well. More importantly, looks good.
That's the only downside, if I remember reading correctly. Klaus formula does come from somebody who graduated from Duke University. Is that kind of against them?
Definitely. Oh yes, what a shot.
15-0.
Moment of magic from Hewitt.
Good interception, but it was all over it. It really has come alive in the last few days. So much energy yesterday. Nesta's serve, that one out wide on the deuce court, it is as good as any I've seen.
Of course, we'll put Leighton numbers through the Klaus calculations. He's averaging 3.13 at the moment, so you've got to whisper. Josh Eagle is on the bench for the Singapore Slammers. Josh, tell us a little bit about what you feel about this particular format, and as a team captain, what you would do differently if you had your time again at the beginning of this 2014 season in this tournament.
Well, I think it's a good question, isn't it? I think we would have probably stuck with a doubles pairing instead of tried to accommodate all the guys and give them all a go. Trying to get a good formula straight up with a good pairing. That certainly hurt our team because, as you see, we've probably used all our guys on numerous occasions. That's one thing. I think these two guys on court probably lack a big serve. So the big servers have tended to dominate in the men's doubles. For me, it's not so much about winning the set 6-3 or 6-2. It's about not losing the set with doing too much damage. So, you know, you just cannot afford to lose a set 6-1 or 6-2, which we've done far too often in this format. So I probably look to, moving forward, try and get your doubles player to have a big serve and also, you know, a good singles player that's got a big serve as well. So that's probably one thing that we could have from the start.
Yeah, that's why we've been keeping tabs on how well the players have done. And I always ask Robbie, you know, what would the captain be expecting as a minimum number of games in any set? And it's always kind of three or four. You don't want heavy losses. And that's where the women are so important as well, aren't they? Because they play a couple of sets. And if you lose the women's singles heavily, Daniela struggled initially for you guys. And then it's an uphill battle, isn't it?
Yeah, it really is. At this format, scoreboard pressure is really important. So I almost believe that, you know, you almost need to go out with your strength at the start, because if you get in front, then it just seems to cause a bit of panic amongst some of the teams and some of the players. So that's really important. And for your female player, I think what's crucial is that she's very handy in doubles. Unfortunately, Danielle has sort of gone off the court now, getting a little bit of treatment on her back. But you look at the good teams. India have done well with Sanya Mirza and Rohan Bopanna. So, you know, your female player needs to be able to play good doubles as well if you've just got one in the team. So, look, this format will evolve moving forward, there's no doubt. It's got years to come, and it's a great format. So I think moving forward, the teams will be looking at getting a really good second female player that is good at doubles. And the same for the men's and the men's singles. They can play a bit of men's singles but also play good doubles. So the platform is there for this format moving forward.
Yeah, Josh, Robbie here alongside Jace again. I agree with you, actually. Just answered my last question. You've got two good singles players, a guy who can have versatility and play good doubles. I think that's vitally important, isn't it? And it's like rotating a squad in soccer. Even if one of the singles guys is tired, not even injured, at least you've got somebody else who can then sub for him.
Look, I think it's the way forward. You look at Thomas Burdish today. He has gone through a massive workload for us. People forget the intensity. He's out here nearly every day playing against a top 10 player. Last night he beat world number one Novak Djokovic. That takes a lot out of the guys. So I think that's where you've got to have a good singles player as a second backup with a big style game. Like, that's where Nick Kyrgios will be good. I think he fits that mould for me. Jack Sock, another up-and-coming American player. So a few of those guys would be good as a number two player, in my opinion.
Josh, always nice chatting. Thanks for your insights, buddy.
Okay, all good.
So the Mavericks have made a nice bright start here. They lead 2-1, 29 overall now.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Dior Homme, Eau for Men, the new fragrance by Christian Dior.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Positive message. How old do you have to be a legend in this competition, Robbie? Could Leighton come back and play lights out as one of those next year?
40.
He's certainly a legend, right?
He is. It's a tricky one. You know, do you go on age? We had this discussion with Fabrice Santoro last night. You know, is it over 40 or is it somebody who's been retired out of the game for X number of years? That's the other way of doing it. I would like to see it probably over 40. That would be my number.
You have to have certain criteria in place, don't you? Because
40.
Legends in that you've played the game for 10, 12, 15 years at the highest level, like Fabrice, or are you a legend because you made a Grand Slam final, or you're a former world number one? So you have to think about these things carefully to make sure that it's a level playing field for the legends. Because you get someone in there too young, it's only just off the tour,
yep,
then they're too good, obviously.
45.
And that's what we've seen with all the legends, isn't it, Chase? Especially with Fabrice, whose legs are still so good, and he's able to outmaneuver the guys, even if they've got big games, so much easier than everybody else. And I think it's been glaringly obvious.
Possibly can. You've got a couple that are very happy trading blows from the baseline. And then, of course, those that are at the net, especially if they're a little old school like Danny, looking across at every available opportunity.
Again, it's a good example of Kohlschreiber so comfortable on the doubles court. There's one on the juice side that inside out back of his. Such a cleanly struck shot. See if he gets involved here, or off a good return from Nesta.
He liked the look of that, didn't he? Went for a full-blooded swing on that return. Something you see that often. Played his best tennis when he has been introduced into the team by captain Josh Eagle. Has really delivered for the Slammers. Mavericks lead 4-1.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Join us at Autosport International and the Performance Car Show, where the world of motorsport meets performance road cars. Get close to amazing racing and road cars and experience the live-action arena at the NEC Birmingham from the 8th to the 11th of January. Don't miss out. Book your tickets today.
Sponsored by Bet365.
There's many of those. It's not down to Pat Rafter, that is it? That miss.
What?
15.
Made the adjustment. Just glanced over the cat after that volley and said, hang on, buddy, this is the one you showed me, not the previous one. This technique.
Bruno's
good, very active at the net, always looking to help out his partner. One of his greatest strengths. Something just an inch over the net all the time. There's Leicester. Just enough spin, not too much. Wiry strength, nice big swing arc, groundies.
Nicely done. Ball just a little higher like that, sort of hip height or just above you. Just give you many more options on the volley. Key there is not to force it. Pretty well there. So we should see her in action. Women's singles up next.
More out than him. Just what you would have wanted.
Can't argue with that, can you? So Mavericks lead, 4-3. The score of Roars, 22-11 now.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Fragrance by Christian Dior.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Bet.
sensational hands there. Again, it's the lack of panic that's so impressive. Things coming straight at you. Lovely hands. He knows that the short one is the most effective one.
Put it. Okay, the Mavericks.
So 5-3 is the lead now for the Mavericks. Had a good day so far. On all three of the sets, a couple of them pretty comfortably. Kolschreiber beating Burdick 6-2. Flipkins and Nesta beating Hantikova and Kyrgios 6-1.
Strokes. Strong legs, good rotation. It's the dynamic duo of power right there.
Trying to stay limber. Word from the locker room is that Hantikova is going to try and warm up. We've got 3 minutes in between sets and see how she feels. And if she feels good enough, she'll be able to play. But if not, then, she might give it a miss.
Okay. Of course, Singapore
lost.
Understand
why she wouldn't take the court if she's in a little bit of a pain there. Mavericks lead 5-4 here, and it's 23-12 now. Back, doesn't it, on the left-hand side.
Time.
And that will bother her when she rotates, and you pretty much rotate each and every shot you use in tennis. Fifth court. Esther's played well, hasn't he, Robbie? Struggled initially. Wasn't getting a lot of court time in Manila with Andy Murray and Maria Sharapova in the team, but once he kind of found his footing and got used to the format, he's played well.
Oh, no surprises there. So a world-class player. Best players at depth.
He got some heavy criticism, didn't he, from teammate Andy Murray?
Andy was. He's giving him a hard time when he had to sub Carlos Moya at one stage. But Danny did say as soon as Andy left, the cancer within the team was gone.
Getting his own back there.
Yes, both those guys got a wicked sense of humour. Dry. That's why they get on so well.
Yeah, they were sat next to each other on the bench, weren't they? A lot. You could see him having a good old giggle there, side of the court.
Murray did say he was having a laugh at Nesta playing singles, and by the time the fourth tier dropped down his cheek, he was feeling sorry for the Canadian.
Two points away now.
42.
Receivers have choice of sides. I think Hewitt's going to take this one.
Yes.
It's good tennis.
Good. Good tennis.
Put a smile on his face, and why not? It's good tennis. In the last 10 days or so, and Philip Kohlschreiber been a great substitute today. The Mavericks take the set 6-4, and they're up 24-12 now.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Dior Homme, Eau for Men, the new fragrance by Christian Dior.
What are you in the mood for? Do you want to have fun with the girls?
I'm ready to take this party by storm, like I'm woman, hear me roar. You're a really good dancer!
So are you!
Thanks, I know!
Are you looking for love?
Such a cliche. You seem like a really nice guy, but why do you think I go on so many bad dates?
You could overthrow an empire.
Spartacus!
That is not my name.
Or become the true detective.
You ever see something like this?
No, sure.
Something happened to a girl, and we need to know if any of you knew her.
Of course I'm dangerous. I'm police.
And uncover the biggest murder mysteries.
Sherlock Holmes, Jane Watson.
He's a criminal genius.
No!
Sorry, I mistook you for your corpse.
Whatever your mood.
Triple smiley face with tongue protruding.
What can I say? I'm in a good mood.
Sky's got it covered with the latest and greatest box sets. Available on demand now.
As the competition reaches its climax,
we think of you as our Magnificent Seven.
Our semi-finalists face their greatest challenge.
You may disagree about important things.
Two sitters, two opposing points of view. But who will find the unique perspective?
I think it's maybe a little bit too bright.
I haven't got enough time.
And make it through to the final.
No, you're losing the image.
Portrait Artist of the Year.
I couldn't call it now, could you?
The semi-final, Tuesday at 8 on Sky Arts 1 HD, or catch up on demand.
Sponsored by Bet365.
So they had to just jiggle with the order of play there a little bit. It was going to be women's singles fourth with men's doubles fifth. But Daniela Handicova just tweaked her upper back or mid-back. The mixed doubles lost to Nesta and Flipkins. So she had a bit of treatment in the locker room, and she's out there now warming up, and she wants to play. She's desperate to do so. So she said she's going to see how it feels, but that didn't look good, did it? You know, the sensible option here, Robbie, surely, is to call it quits, right?
Yeah, of course, only she knows how bad it feels. She's been working out hard in the gym. Of course, last thing you want to do is any major damage.
Mm.
got about still a good 2 or 3 weeks of training before you're hitting the match courts. It's a crucial period now. Should be well into a training block. Certainly don't want that to be disrupted by a major injury. It's going to set you back for 2 weeks. 2 weeks at this stage is of vital importance.
Especially given this set. Pretty much a dead rubber, isn't it? Can't win the overall title. That's gone for Mike Max Indian Aces. So good attitude. Want to get out there. Support your team. Entertain the fans. I think she might get out there and give it a couple of games. See how it goes. No substitutes on the Slammers bench. That's the problem. Plenty of men, but not so many women. Kiki Mladenovic came in for Caroline Wozniacki yesterday in the singles. And of course, one or two of the teams have had a couple of women available to them throughout the competition. Maria Sharapova was in initially for the Mavericks in Manila. So Kirsten Plitkins has spent a bit of time on the sidelines there while Maria played the singles and mixed doubles. Serena Williams was in the house, wasn't she, for the Slammers, so Daniela was the reserve then. She said yesterday she learnt a lot being on the bench with the likes of Serena Williams and Andre Agassi, Pat Rafter, Leighton Hewitt. Great champions down the years. That's one of the reasons why she's thoroughly enjoyed herself. And I guess that's the main reason she wants to get out there this afternoon
final
and
set,
continue to play for
Manila,
the team.
Maverick
takes her responsibility very seriously. Sets, try and get the women's singles underway here. Just be a question of whether Daniela Hantikova's back is up to the task. I'm sure she's going to give it a go for a couple of games. She's up against Kirsten Plitkins. It's a lovely serve. That's a shot that Hantikova does miss a lot. So she's got to be careful, can't use it all the time. I think much better in a situation like that to go centre or cross court, especially early on in the match.
40-50.
Of course, she has lovely long levers, Hantikova, so she takes big cuts at the ball. So she needs that rotation. And that's why that little injury she's picked up in her back, you know, might hinder her here.
Well, I'm delighted to say we got the Manila Mavericks team manager with us, Jean-Henri Lullier. Jean-Henri, thank you very much for chatting with us. And Robbie Koenig here. And Jean-Henri, we'd just love to get your thoughts on your team and how the IPTL has gone for you as one of the owners.
You know, it's been a great experience for me and also the players. Four legs. Unfortunately, we had a tough match 2 nights ago, but looks like we're, you know, getting back here and end this season strong with a win today.
Talking about ending the season strong, I think you started it beautifully in Manila. I think the reception that we all got in Manila, I think, surprised even Jason and I.
Yes, there are a lot of tennis fans in Manila, and especially having, you know, this large caliber of players back home really put tennis back in the map in the Philippines. And you know, the fans really stay there from start till end. And I really believe that the Philippine fans really enjoy the IPTL.
Yeah, and I think when we go back there next year, I think we're going to see the fans embracing the local teams even more. I think that's something we're going to see in each of the cities. Would you go along with that?
Definitely. I think it's new to us all, and it's a new experience for all the fans. But No, this year, I think IPDL has put a dent in, into the tennis fans and brought in a lot of fans that are also not really into tennis. So I think it's done well.
And having a look at the teams and now getting a good feel for what it's all about, what sort of changes do you think you might make next year? Extra singles players, maybe an extra doubles player in the team. What do you think as far as that's concerned?
I definitely think that, yes, all the team owners will take a look at the quality of benches that we're going to have. You know, it's a pretty long season with these four legs, and it does take a toll on the player, so having a slightly larger bench would be an advantage to everybody.
Final question overall. Do you see yourselves being involved for longevity over a long period of time with your team? Are you really happy with the concept going forward as well?
Yes, the experience has been good, and you know, the shareholders of the Philippine Mavericks or Manila Mavericks are looking at this as a long term. And yes, hopefully we'll all be here together with all the other team owners involved here today.
I think it's going to be really competitive down the line, Sean Henry. We thank you for talking with us, and we really enjoyed our time when we were in Manila with you and your team, and hope it finishes well for you guys. That certainly looks like it is.
Thank you very much, and looking forward to the IPL for 2015.
Power. Thanks, Sean Henry.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Manila Mavericks are calling happiness.
Did well that. Faced with the power points. No panic. Back seems to be okay. She can obviously feel a little discomfort, but not too much for to quit. As JLD Yaga, captain of the UAE Royals, so he was bitterly disappointed yesterday evening off the back of that loss. So we had a chat with him at the hotel, and he said the whole team were. Suddenly they were thinking about all the missed opportunities in each and every match that they had lost over the course of the format. But a little too late. He said, good learning curve. Everybody is desperate to be back this time next year and to win the trophy. So it's spurred them on, that loss.
I mean, just like we were strategizing, so was he. Some of the team members and some of the team owners already yesterday evening thinking about, is it better to have an extra singles player in the mix? Should you have a double specialist? And I think that's what's going to be interesting next year. I think the captains are going to be a lot more involved in the draft, as are the team owners.
Oh, wonderful shot that was. Fabulous.
Oh, this is an absolute beauty. Kaboom! From Kirsten.
It's an interesting point you make, and I think that's the right decision, isn't it? You've got to get the captains involved. Because they know the team they want to put out, and they know the options that they want available to them through the course of the competition. Good start by the Mavericks. Lipkins hit the ball very cleanly indeed. She leads Sanakova 2-1.
Sponsored by Bet365.
At Richer Sounds, we're passionate about bringing your music and movies to life. For amazing colour and clarity, why not upgrade to this Panasonic 50-inch 4K smart TV for just $1,299? With a friendly team of experts and fully qualified installers at our 53 stores nationwide, we'll make your home entertainment dream come true.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Time. Fifteen. fifth inning.
Certainly have been appreciated on the slammer's bench.
Exquisite. You've seen plenty of that from the likes of Hewitt and Rafter.
Up the course. It's important that you're ready to make any adjustments and maintain your balance as you're moving up the court. Too casual here.
Bit of athleticism. Daniela making some good shot selection as well.
That's a nice feel. Very best volleys in the world. So good at taking pace off the attempted pass as opposed to trying to hit the volley harder than that shot. Has choice of sides on the deciding point. Hantikova much prefers to return from the ad court than the juice.
Game.
Good tennis. Just enough spin on that forehand.
Bring it to two.
She hits well. Flipkins leads Hantikova 3-2. The Mavericks are up 27-14.
Sponsored by Bet365. Join us at Autosport International and the Performance Car Show, where the world of motorsport meets performance road cars. Get close to amazing racing and road cars and experience the live-action arena at the NEC Birmingham from the 8th to the 11th of January. Don't miss out. Book your tickets today.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Got a fan in the house. It's never good.
Tell you what, you Leeds guys that don't have too many fans, do you?
Yeah, we're hardcore.
Yeah. So who would Leeds fans be friendly with as far as footballing circles are concerned?
Nobody. We love to be hated.
Okay.
That's our mantra. No one loves us, we don't care. That's a lovely shot. I think a few famous Leeds fans, aren't there? Stefan Edberg, Leeds fan back in the day, of course. Of this generation, we were great in the 70s, weren't we? So lots of guys our age that Leeds fans. This season. Got that Italian dude in charge of us now. He's wreaking havoc at the club.
Because, I must admit to knowing Leeds pretty well, because one of your stalwarts was actually South African, wasn't it?
Lucas
Radebe.
He was good, man. Quality.
Captain fantastic.
I think we bought about five at the time. A couple of them panned out pretty well. Didn't hear too much about the other three. Philemon Masinga, here's another one. Mm-hmm. Not too, South Africa. Good. And of course, they played for the Premiership. And that's where the band named themselves after that team. They're Leeds fans as well, obviously.
Also one of the biggest teams in South Africa, if not the biggest teams, together with Orlando Pirates.
So an opportunity here for Flipkins to break.
So much feel on that back end. Just have the thought process of trying to roll that one slow cross court. No panic. Got to trust your feel.
This sets. We're still struggling a little bit with that back injury. Hopkins leads 4-2 now. Just missed a few too many of those this afternoon. I admire the attitude of wanting to get out there and compete, even though she is a little injured. So definitely a little short of her best. So Flipkins just a game away now. Big win this for the Mavericks. They lead 29-14 against the Slammers.
Sponsored by Bet365.
At Richer Sounds, we're passionate about bringing your music and movies to life. This LG 49-inch 4K smart TV is just $899, giving you the perfect picture at an incredible price. With a friendly team of experts and fully qualified installers at our 53 stores nationwide, we'll make your home entertainment dream come true.
Sponsored by Bet365.
On the big screen, having a bit of fun. That's what it's all about. Hantikova needing to hold serve here to stay in the set. Spooky tennis. Just to see Daniela trying one or two new things here. Serving and volleying a little bit this evening. Doing a work with JL Diaga, start of 2015, who's obviously captain of the Royals here. He said he wants to work hard on trying to improve her volleys, trying to improve the options available to her during a match. You know, nice to see her coming in once or twice.
15.
He also said he wanted to try and help her become more independent thinking on the court. Trusting her own instincts. Oh. It's the tougher shot. She normally likes to go cross-course with the high backhand volley. I think out of the corner of her eye, she saw that Hantikova had anticipated that. Much tougher to try and hit that one aggressively down the line there. It's a lovely serve. It's a favourite. And that's it with just a little bit of slice.
Another number is leading 5-0.
Flipkins serving for it now.
Thank you.
It's a lovely serve. She's played well this afternoon. Solid, she's given her best efforts at each and every set that she's played for the Mavericks. A couple of occasions, she's been found wanting, a little frustrated. She's lacked the necessary firepower to overcome most of her opponents, but never falter for a lack of effort. Still match point.
Okay.
That'll do nicely.
Set
the tennis set for Kirsten Plipkins. Nice to finish on a high. She beats Daniela Hantikova 6-3. And the Mavericks have won all five of the sets this afternoon against the DBS Singapore Slammers. So again, very nice for the Mavericks to finish on a high with a win. But Paul Schreiber played well. He was in for Joe Wolf and Songa today. They win 30-15.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Where's your stuff?
Right here, babe, on my HP stream.
Are all your snaps on there?
Yeah, it's got loads of cloud storage and OneNote to sync my lists. And I made the party invite on here.
I so need one.
And the best part? It's less than £200.
Why didn't you tell me she was back in town? Do I need to explain to you how dangerous Olivia's return is to this White House?
How long is she here for?
I don't know. What a wicked thing to do, to make me dream of you, and I don't want to fall in love. I won't see her. No, I
don't want to fall in love. The brand new series of Scandal starts 8th of January at 10 on Sky Living HD, or catch series 1 to 3 on demand.
I still don't understand why you're leaving us, Aggie.
Because that's always been the plan.
But what are you going to do in the Cotswolds?
Build a home, fit in.
Tell me, what normally wins the quiche competition?
The winner of the best quiche is...
I did not murder anyone.
You prove there's a murderer in the village, people will stop blaming you. You might even be liked.
Agatha Raisin?
Yes? I'm telling you, there's something going on here.
There are suspects everywhere.
Police!
What is wrong with you people?
Agatha Raisin and the Quiche of Death, Boxing Day at 8 on Sky One HD.
International tour manager.
Dominique Bad Guy?
It's pronounced Bad G. It's French.
Oh. Muppets Most Wanted. Available Friday on Sky Movies Premiere.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Thank also the IPTL and Mahesh Bhupathi for getting me here. It's been a great honor for me, nice experience. Get to know a lot of persons, personalities, and it's been an honor for me to be here.
Been an honor to watch you play. Well done. Carlos, the end of what has been a terrific couple of weeks, starting in Manila and then to Singapore, Delhi, and here we are in Dubai. What's been the highlight from Carlos Moya's perspective?
For me, highlight was to have the chance to be the captain of this unbelievable team. We've been fighting so hard. We were very close to being in contention for the title, but we lost a couple of matches for 1 point or for one game. So, you know, very happy to be here. I think it's a new experience. It's this new format. It's unbelievable fun for the players, good for the crowd, good for everybody. So I was happy to be here for in the first year.
It has been terrific. Carlos, to you and the Manila Mavericks, thank you. And to Josh Eagle also, and the DBS Singapore Slammers, thank you.
good stuff from the Mavericks, and of course they move up into second place, but the Micromax Indian Aces have already been crowned champions. But they've still got one match to play. They take on the UAE Royals at about 7:30 local time, and of course the DBS Singapore Slammers, who are bottom of the pile with 24 points, but they have been highly entertaining. So that means we've got about 45 minutes or so before the players take to the courts for the very last match here. And it gives us an opportunity to rewind and show you exactly what happened on New Delhi in day three, the match between the Aces and the Royals. We're going to start with men's doubles, and then I'm going to show you the match that everybody was talking about, Roger Federer against Novak Djokovic. Enjoy this. It's a 5-minute shootout.